Hi, I'm Peter Singh. I'll be sharing with you a little bit about my journey. The following clip is a clip of me speaking at the Super Conference at Wembley Stadium, and I hope you enjoy it, and I'll catch up with you on the other side.
So get everything out of your mind so you are fully 100% listening to this man, because what you're about to hear on the stage, you will not believe. Mark didn't believe it. He went on Google and typed in the thing that happened to Pete and found it. And he said, Rob, that was really real. I went, I know, because Pete told me. But Mark didn't believe this. So, this man, Mr. Peter Singh, had a few challenges when he got into HMOs. Don't worry, I'll share that with you later on. Had a few challenges when he got into HMOs and business. And Pete, I want you to, first of all, tell us your net income, your portfolio, and tell us how you're doing so far. So just put us in the picture on how you're doing now.
At the moment, net income from the multi-let strategy I'm doing is £6,000 per month.
Okay, so that's the net income after costs.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, how does it feel to have that kind of money?
Yeah, it feels good.
Yeah?
It feels good. To get to that, it took a lot of hard work, but it's starting to pay off, so.
Sure. Okay. So, we need to do this in about 3 or 4 minutes, Peter. Take us back to what happened before you got into, you know, kind of like the HMO business.
Yeah, I mean, basically, I used to be a gambler. Basically, I spent a lot of my life gambling, losing money. There came a time in my life when I started to make money. My friends wanted to be part of that. When I started to make money. In a nutshell, they pressured me to gamble with their money. And I gave in to the pressures at the time. And when I first gambled with the money, they made a little bit of money, and they put a little bit of money in. Then they put more money in, and I gave in to the pressures. Then they wanted to put more money. That money was lost. Then I was facing some serious death threats, which... Yeah, so I was basically facing some serious death threats, and these people wanted money from me. I come from a fairly poorly working class family. And I turned to my father for help. My father could see the pain, and he wanted to help. In the end, he raised £19,000 for these people through loans. They'd taken the money from my father with agreement that they would leave me alone after that. Briefly going into it, they took my passport from me and some documents. A few months down the line, multi-million pound VAT fraud was committed by them. I was arrested by the police. My house was raided by the police. I was threatened to give no comment interviews at the police station, which I did. I had a solicitor in place that was provided to me by the gang. I didn't have the freedom to say what I wanted to say. Eventually, it took me a long time, about 2 years, to build the courage to stand up for myself. I changed solicitor, and then I was threatened again, and I gave in. And basically, I had to make a decision at that point, whether I'm going to stand up properly or not, and I decided to take a stand. And I did speak the truth when I got to court. It was part of a 3.5 month trial, and I was acquitted in June of last year.
Now you can imagine my dilemma in whether we share this with you or not. Although probably a little bit nervous, Peter, you did want to share this, didn't you, here?
Yes, that's right. Can you tell us why? One of my visions and goals is to inspire as many people as I can. One of the things that I want to be able to do is be able to share my journey and experiences to help people to realise that it doesn't matter what obstacles we face in life, it doesn't matter what circumstances we've got, we can fight through our obstacles and overcome them and really move our lives in the right direction.
Are your parents here?
I did want them to come. I did get them tickets. They were on holiday. I was going to surprise them. They extended their tickets. Unfortunately, they were unable to come.
Sure. Okay. Never mind. Another time. So, take forward to now. Yeah? You did good. So, how long did it take you to build up your multi-let without the sweat portfolio, which is the no money down multi-let strategy, by the way? How long did it take you? And has it been a fun journey? And has it had its challenges? And just share with us for a minute about that.
Well, basically, it took me since March of last year I started. I took my first multi-let on in March. I paid £1,100 rent for it. It was £280 overheads, council tax and stuff. That house cash flowed £950. The next multi-let I got was in June. Between March and June, I wasn't getting many... there wasn't many houses coming on the market. But I was using that time to build rapport with estate agents while there was no houses coming on the market. A lot of the estate agents were giving me a lot of rejection even before I got the first one. In that three-month period, I built a lot of experience in terms of what I was looking for, what I wanted to do, what kind of business model I wanted to create. And I did realise from the first house that I took that through the five rooms that I'd multi-letted, I was basically cash flow 950, and I thought those were my targets, that I'd set my benchmark from there. And basically, in June, I took on my second multi-let, which was, that was also £1,100, 240 utilities overheads. That house cash flow £729. Within that time, because I'd done so many viewings, I'd basically realised that there was one house in particular that was on the right move, which was quite appealing to me. Well, it wasn't appealing, it wasn't really interesting, but what had happened was it was on the market for so long and nothing was coming on. I thought, well, I might as well go and check it out anyway. I went to check it out. The thing that made me check that house out was the fact that it was, I'd realised through experience of viewing houses now that the kitchen and the bathrooms were basically giveaways of the quality of a house. If you have a house with a nice kitchen and a nice bathroom, it represents a lot about the house. The picture was rubbish. I mean, it had a picture of the room and there was no kitchen and bath. I went and checked it out, quite a long story short, and the house was the best multi-let that I've got. It's so nice. Lovely, and I just snapped it up straight away, and it was just the estate agent basically done a really poor job of getting the advert done properly.
So just pause there, Pete. So remember the opportunities that arise from the challenges that happen through other people. Do you think this is... I mean, you've gone out and done it, but let's be fair, you had a big reason why.
Yeah, that's right.
A very big reason why. And I think that's why Daniel shared the lucky model. Because... was failure an option to you, do you think?
No, failure is not an option. Success is the only way. We're going to fail towards success, but we've just got to use it to move forward and push sure. for what we want.
Okay, so please stand up. Please do stand up. Pete's going to be at the back there. He's going to hang around all weekend. If you want to have a chat with him, I'm sure he'll get mobbed. Please just give a huge round of applause. Mr. Peter Singh. Cheers, Pete. Well done. Yeah, come on, give him some more love. Well done, Peter.
Hi, great to catch up with you again. I hope you enjoyed the clip. Please feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel, where I'll be sharing a little bit more about my journey. Below are a few links to my website, petersingh.co.uk. I'm currently running a property training event, Multi-Let Success Strategy, where I'll be training people to benefit through property investing with low initial funds, using the same strategy that I've used to become financially independent.
And there's also links to reserve the book, which I'm currently writing at the moment. I hope you enjoyed the clip, and thank you for taking the time out to listen. And I hope to hear from you soon.